Monsters. It's probably one of my favorite PS2 games. I'm playing it on... well, it has a PS4 version on both PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4. And the PlayStation 4 version you can play on PlayStation 5. Alright. So, Let's see what we can do here. Oh, hang on. There we go. So, we'll start. Wrong start button. we're gonna do adventure. And then we're going to So all the monsters are based off of, you know, actual movie monsters, but they couldn't get the rights. So we have Raptros, who's kind of like Rodan mixed with King Ghidorah. We have Togera, who is obviously supposed to be like Godzilla. We have Praetor, which is kind of supposed to be like I have a list here. It is supposed to be like the Deadly Mantis, and then there's an alternate skin where it looks like a giant ant, like the movie Them. Kongar, who is obviously supposed to be King Kong. Robo 47, who's kind of like the 1950s sci-fi style robot. Agumo, who's like just he's a Daimajin, which is like a kind of living statue, and actually a movie. Ultra V, who's very much like Mazinger, with an alternate skin that resembles EVA Unit 01. Magmo, who's just a giant, magma monster. Kinetoclops, who's a human who got turned into like an electricity monster. And Zorgulon, who's just kind of like the generic 1950s big brain alien. And all their fourth costumes are like something special. So for Raptros, for the fourth costume, there's a skeleton. It unfortunately doesn't show on the screen here. For Togera, the fourth costume is like a devil dinosaur type thing. Praetor, we're gonna find out, because those are the two I need to unlock. With Kongar, the last one is Crystal Kongar. Robo 47, it's like a exoskeleton type robot thing. Agamo's fourth costume is actually Mecha Sweet Tooth from Twisted Metal Black. I'm not even kidding. Ultra V's fourth costume is like very kind of Sailor Moon-esque almost. It's a little more sleek than this design. Magmo's fourth costume, I actually don't know off the top of my head. Kinetoclops' fourth costume is a swamp monster, and Zorgulon's fourth costume is an even weirder looking alien. So, today we're going to play as Kongar to celebrate the release of Godzilla vs. Kong, both in theaters and on HBO Max in North America. We're just going to do the regular costume. And I'm a little rusty, so forgive me if my gameplay isn't so great. This is also the first time I'm playing this on my monitor rather than my TV. And the camera in this game is not great. Gastra? Oh, I have to use my special. Alright. So there are two specials in the box. A long range special and a... Oh, he got killed by fire. Alright. a long range special like you saw, and a close range special. Most of the close range specials are the same, or like a different colored version of the same thing. And then all the long range specials are specific to each monster. Oh, Togera! Oh, we gotta get into some King Kong versus Godzilla action up in here. Although instead of being in Hong Kong, it's in Las Vegas. Oh, I mean Gambler's Gold, not Las Vegas. And you get shiny hands. I never figure out what they actually do. If they boost your attack or what. But it's a fun thing to do. Oh, it's okay, I still have 2 lives left. This is what I meant when I said I was rusty. I've eaten this game so many times. So there's a power up that turns you invisible for some reason. And it's not the very... it's an okay power up. You can still kind of see their silhouette. I forgot how much I need. But we'll just go until we get a game over. And then we'll see if we have enough. So these are the alternate Praetor costumes that may be an homage to the ant from them. Now it's time for the first boss. Goliath Prime. Who is this guy? He's a giant robot. And he throws bombs. Thing I don't like about the boss fight is you have to throw them back. And you only have limited time to do so. Starts flashing red. It goes green, yellow, red. And red means you don't have a lot of time left. Green means you have a while. Yellow means you have a while. Oh, what? That's been happening. I'm gonna jinx it right now, but I'm actually doing pretty well compared to the last time I fought this guy. I got him, but he got me, too. And here's second phase. Thank you. down like that. And if you get caught in that, yeah, that happens. It's very not good. And, well, luckily I have another life still. I think my last. Nope. No, I have two lives. So this life, and then I have another life. Nice thing about this one. It's not getting slapped around. Yeah, first boss now. I don't know if I'm gonna play through the whole story. Just enough to unlock the couple of boss rooms I need. I'll check at the like 30-minute mark. This. And the nice thing, and I'm sure you've noticed, is that they all have little posters. Each battlefield has like a poster for it, like it, as if the monster was actually in the movie. Ha ha. switch back. We're gonna switch back the difficulty because this time we're gonna cost. Yep, it's Mecha. Thank you. Praetor now? Oh, this is not looking good. We'll go back to doing the story. Oh, yeah, we're gonna jump ahead a little bit. So dramatic when they fall. Thank you. It's like Biolante, but not. Do we have to restart? Oh, Vegan. Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, about time. Hopefully we got a good amount of points or tokens. So we have 52, so we can unlock this. Oh. I did 100% it. All right. Let's screenshot this. I 100%ed it. It's unfortunate it doesn't have a platinum. I know it's weird because it's a PS2 on PS4 game, but there are other PS2 on PS4 games that have platinums. So, why would this one not be given one? I don't know. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys all next time.